This is the SAP Developer News for June 20th, 2024.
Hello, ABAP developers. We all know business objects are the building blocks for modeling data. Well, business object interfaces are provided by SAP in order to release business objects so that it can be used or extended by customers using the ABAP Cloud development model. Now, by defining the stability contracts, it is possible to use such C1 released business object within other software components. Now, once you have used these business objects, you might want to create your own custom UI. In order to make it easier for customers to build custom UIs on top of the released business objects, SAP has provided a new wizard as part of the ABAP development tools in the latest release of SAP BTP ABAP environment. Now, in this tutorial, our friend Andrew Fisher shows how you can use this wizard to generate your own custom UI on top of the SAP C1 released business object interface, a bank TP. In this way, you can leverage growing number of released business objects that are based on ABAP RESTful application programming model to create your own UI on top as extension in ABAP Cloud. The link to this tutorial is in the description below. Kindly check it out.
Making sure you're running the correct versions of software with the latest bug fixes and features is a pretty important task. Scale this up to an enterprise the size of SAP, a producer and consumer of many, many open source libraries and packages, and this becomes a mammoth undertaking with those libraries, packages, and dependencies that are involved. There are many teams internally at SAP who have turned to the open source tool Renovate and use it at scale for this dependency management work. If this sounds interesting to you and you want to find out more, then we've got an upcoming SAP open source webinar just for you. On the 25th of June, join Tobias Gabriel, a senior developer in the open source program office, who will explain how SAP uses Renovate at scale, and also we'll talk about the shift, the paradigm shift towards the automation of dependency management in enterprises like SAP. All the details about this webinar and how to register are in the description.
Hello, SAP community. Wouldn't it be fun to share your code with your teammates? That's exactly what you can do with a build code project from the SAP Build Lobby. If you're interested in learning how to enable SAP Build Code in your BTP account, check out this tutorial. When you create a new full stack project from the Build Lobby, you will provide a project name, description, and select a dev space. If a dev space doesn't already exist, a new one will be created for you. Once your project is open, you can add any Git-based repository as a remote repo using the simplified Git panel. To share the project with your team members, we'll also need to add them as collaborators in the GitHub settings. In the SAP Build Lobby, you will find an option called Manage Members for your Build Code project. This feature allows you to authorize your team members to access the project as long as they have access to the same sub-account. Your team members can then access the project by selecting a dev space and providing their credentials. The repository will be cloned onto their dev space. If you need more guidance, Rupa has written a fantastic blog with step-by-step instructions. You can find the link in the description below.
Hola, SAP developers. As part of the announcements that we had for SAP SAPA, it was announced that there will be a new functionality in API management called the API Anomaly Detection. Now, my colleague Shruti recently published a blog post which shows you how to enable the functionality and also what should you expect from this new functionality. There is also a very nice infographic that my colleague Kasturi created, which really distills what the functionality is. So make sure to check that out as well. There is now a new capability in SAP Integration Suite, which is the Event Mesh capability. So now, Event Mesh is within the different capabilities that are part of SAP Integration Suite. Check out the blog post by Carsten, where he basically shares with us what you should expect from this new capability. And if you want to see that capability in action, this week I had the opportunity to do a live stream where I basically go through the entire process of activating the new capability. Also, I connected to a CAP application, consume messages from cloud integration. We also connected to an S4 HANA cloud. So make sure to check that out so that you can see the capability in action.